Tika Sumpner, Tiffany Haddish, Maya Destiny, and even made her way into the Wakanda movie. Mm-hmm. Please welcome Phaedra Sandell. Yay!
Thank you guys for having me.
You are absolutely gorgeous.
You are.
Like, I'm wrong for sometimes the way I think, mm-hmm. because I did not think that you were going to be this gorgeous.
What is insane with you? I think you think stunt women look like...
masculine.
She think anybody that do something that's masculine is ugly.
Well, No. Don't believe that. Okay. It's not completely forthcoming.
Forthcoming.
I do kind of believe, in my mind, I thought you were going to be, a little muscular.
And everyone thinks that.
Brolic and masculine, and you're not.
You
kind of look like you're having some feelings about this.
But there's nothing wrong with women having muscles.
There is a stereotype with stunt women,
Thank you. So you appreciate me keeping it real, right?
Okay.
So what made you become a stunt woman?
Well, I always wanted to do action movies. Like, my favorite movies are Kill Bill and The Matrix.
Yeah,
so growing up, I was like, oh my goodness, I just love action movies. And so when I moved to LA when I was 26, I had a 4-year-old daughter. And, I used to do background work because I really moved there to do acting. Mm-hmm. And so I would see people on set, jump off buildings, get hit, and I'm like, I can do that. I want to do that. And so I had to hustle my way up and, ask coordinators, hey, how can I be a stunt woman? They were like, there's not many black stunt women at all. Mm. So it's definitely a need mm-hmm. for more women. And he gave me some advice, like, you should train at these locations and, submit a reel of yourself, mm-hmm. showcasing your skills and a resume. And I started doing that.
Yeah. I can honestly say I've never watched someone jump off of a building and say, I want to do that.
Right.
But I love hearing your story. I mean, mm-hmm. because people see the glory, but they got to know the meat and potatoes that got you there. The true story, right?
It's
and that, I know, that's just, but now you talked about LA, you talked about your daughter. Mm-hmm. What was really interesting to me hearing your story is how when you got to LA with your child, you wound up homeless for a period of mm-hmm. time. And can you speak to that? Because I think it'll be really inspirational for people to hear mm-hmm. how you got out from under.
Okay. Well, I had a 4-year-old daughter and I was renting out a room for a while. And when I moved to LA, I had like $3,500 in the bank. And I left Houston, I'm from Houston. So I left Houston because I felt like I had nothing to lose. And I got tired of a regular 9-to-5. And I really wanted to pursue my dreams. And, people always say, oh, I want to do this, I want to do that, but what's holding you back is your procrastination. Mm. And so I told myself that I know I'm going to be successful because I'm determined, I have a child, I'm a single parent, I have a child to feed. So I moved out there, money started running low, even driving LA, 45 minutes to go here, to go there, mm-hmm. Doing background work, making $8 an hour. And when you get your check, you have like $40-something left. Mm. And so I started running out of money and I lived in a motel for a while. And this is when I really started to hustle. I was going to different sets, passing out my headshot and resume to stunt coordinators, coming up with choreography by myself. To showcase it, and one day somebody gave me a chance on set of Real Husbands of Hollywood. Was my first stunt gig.
What was Real what?
Real Husbands of Hollywood.
Yes, I do.
With Kevin Hart. Yeah.
But when you got that break, like how did it happen? How did it occur?
I was actually doing background work on set, and I was like, hey, my name is Phaedra, I do stunts. I'm trying to get into stunts. And the stunt coordinator was William Washington, and the AD was, his name is Spoon, mm. and he introduced me to William Washington, and he was like, you got a good look, and I do have a stunt coming up. She's about your complexion and your height. Her name is Raquel. Mm-hmm. She played, Kevin Hart's girlfriend, the one that was speaking Spanish mm-hmm. and stuff, and he said, send me your stuff. And I did, and I got hired.
So were you into martial arts? Were you a boxer? Did you dance? How did you learn how to do all of these crazy, amazing stunts? You gotta have some skill.
Well, for 4 years, I did karate when I was younger. Mm-hmm. I did also used to dance was my minor in college, but it's with dancing, it helps choreography.
Yes.
So I was able to choreograph my own fight scenes and,
Oh, wow.
And then you always win. Yeah.
And I did train. I trained at Bob Yerkes' backyard doing mm-hmm. high falls for like 6 months. I was like, ain't nobody gonna ever hire me for no high falls. And I got so tired, you guys. And it's like, I'm the only black stunt woman who knows how to do high falls now. So I get called to do those all the time.
So what are some of the obstacles that you've had to overcome?
Look at
I mean, because you've mentioned that, my God, today, that's an obstacle right there, child. You've mentioned that you're the only, like, it's not a lot of black stunt women. So what are some of the obstacles you've had to overcome being the only black stunt woman?
Well, for one, the lack of diversity in TV and film. Mm-hmm. I mean, we can't double anybody if there's no black
right.
ladies.
There it is.
So
there it is.
I just thank you so much for all the black women, Viola Davis, Tiffany Haddish, everybody to make opportunities for us stunt women, because, you know, there's not enough, it's not enough work. But now, you know, it's becoming more diverse, and so, you know, you have strong black leads leading action movies and films, and you know, we're able to work because of them. So
that's deep, that, yeah. that the lack of diversity, the fact, the intentionality behind not hiring us, mm-hmm. it trickles
it
down.
Trickles to everybody. Just,
exactly. Right, yeah. That is ridiculous.
Phaedra, what's been one of your favorite stunts that you've done, one of your character stunts you've done?
Avengers Infinity War and Endgame.
I know that's right.
Yes, Wakanda Forever. I actually had to shave my head bald. Bald.
You have one of those heads that's pretty bald or with hair. See, not everybody can do that. You look beautiful.
You could put none of those little masks
they
on
would
your
not.
Head.
And you know,
oh, no.
We shaved our head bald for 2 months. Every day in the morning, we had to get our hair shaved.
No mamula.
And I walked around bald, but you know what? It gave me so much confidence. Like, I'm not my hair.
Your hair is long now, honey. How long did it take for it to grow back?
Well, my hair is like 10 inches now, so it's been 2 years, so my hair is 10 inches now.
Ain't no way. I'd have passed on that one.
Well, I think you look beautiful there.
Thank you. But not probably the coin probably would have been long.
I thought about the bigger picture.
Yeah, it's the bigger
picture.
So
I'm going to forget this hair, you know.
What would you say to young girls right now watching, and they're thinking, this could be a career. I mean, I felt a connection with her, and I, too, see people jump off of buildings and want to do that, too. I don't know. You are crazy. But what would you say to young girls who aspire to do what you're doing right now?
I would say the only thing that's stopping you from opportunity is yourself. Go out there, train, link up with some people who believe in you, who want to see you succeed. Learn the craft, you know, because people, you know, probably at home watching TV, oh, I just want to sit on my butt. No, just go do it.
I want to learn how to do a stunt or something. Will you teach us?
Of course.
All right, so we'll be back with a lesson from Phaedra on how to throw a punch.
That's crazy.
Okay, that's not a stunt. That's we are back, and Phaedra is going to teach us how to throw a punch.
This is all on you, Trina. You wanted to do this stunt.
Okay, let's do it.
Do it on Trina.
This is a stunt?
Well, you know, choir like Trina. They like doing stuff.
What you got, sis? What
okay,
you got?
It's all about camera angles. Speaking for the camera, and with a little bit of acting. So who am I?
I got my camera angle.
Are you hitting me?
Oh, I can.
Oh, you can hit me. Okay, so camera's right here, right?
Okay.
So,
look how excited.
This is your fight stance. So, what you're gonna do is when you hit me, you're gonna go past the eyes to the ear.
I'm just
so it looks like you hit me. And so, what my job is to react when you hit me. So, you're gonna punch me.
Okay, ready?
Make sure it goes right here. So, camera.
Ooh, it looks like I'm gonna take this one and go across like that.
That's a little too close. Let me move.
Okay, ready?
So, go ahead.
Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh! There you go.
I'm getting
you. Okay,
you got it.
All right, let's do it again. So you're gonna do the 1-2 punch. You're gonna do 1-2. Okay, you ready?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh!
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 You're
like, hey, I'm sorry, Selena, I'm gonna do it. You were trying.
Why you wanna do me? For joining us today. Please make sure you follow her on Instagram @Phaedra Sandell so you can keep up with her. Thanks so much for joining us today on Sister Circle Live.